Welcome to the His Call Technology Podcast, where we are communicating tomorrow's business needs today. From just outside Nashville, Tennessee, join His Call as we discuss all things telephony, data, and infrastructure related to business leaders. Here we go.
Welcome to the His Call Technology Podcast. This is your host, Chuck. On today's episode, our guest is Rich Bott with XMedius. Welcome, Rich.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Well, I'm glad to have you. This is the second episode XMedius has joined us. On a recent episode, Tom Menefee joined us to discuss UC and contact center applications on their XM Connect platform. Rich, can you share a little bit with our listeners about yourself and your role at XMedius?
Sure. Just to give you an idea, I started in the industry back in 1994 when I went to work for a small company called Infinite Technologies, and we sold fax servers. Through the years, I worked for a couple of the competitors to XMedius, but the whole time I've been involved in the fax environment. I guess it's about 12 years ago with XMedius, and I've been with the company ever since in the sales engineering type of role, which my title is the director of the solution architects for the organization. So I basically oversee all the sales engineers, helping understand how the products fit into customer areas and things.
So tell us a little bit about XMedius. Tom gave some overview last time, but we've kind of focused on the UC, CC side of things. So tell us a little bit about XMedius, from you.
Okay. So XMedius is one of those global companies. We have, a headquarters in Montreal with offices in Seattle and Paris. In the fax side of things, we are one of the leaders of the market. We've been doing IP-based faxing since 1993. So before I even got in the industry, this company has been doing fax over IP. There's, over 14,000 different fax over IP installations globally, with over 3 billion faxes handled every year by our software. It's really one of those companies that has gotten in. They wrote the application themselves. We own the software. We own the IP rights. Things are patented within the software. And we really just took fax seriously and really tried to concentrate on making sure that we could give the best product to the market.
The product portfolio is pretty broad. We talked about fax. We mentioned XM Connect, the UC platform. You also have other secure file transfer applications?
Yes. In fact, one of the things that we looked at is we had a few people ask us questions about sending faxes, and we have this Send Secure product that we came up with. And the idea behind it was not everything can be faxed. When you get into audio files in today's day and age with video capture for like policemen and things, they need ways of being able to transfer those documents easily and for those files to get to their destination in a secure manner. For example, one of our customers out in Alaska, their school district, they record all of the files by their security officers. But since some of those high school students are over 18, all of the information has to be sent to the court systems if there's a fight at a football game or something, and it has to be done securely. So we wanted to give them an option of being able to send those files as securely as you would with fax, but in a different format. So we came up with a real easy, simple to use file delivery system in SendSecure that just drops the file off, encrypts all of the transaction, and then gives you the whole record of the transaction after it's been delivered to the other side. And we can prove that it was in the same format it was when it was first delivered or uploaded to the system.
Isn't it interesting how companies evolve? You've got a particular application you're working, a need comes up, you address that need, and a whole new product develops out of that.
Oh yeah. It's a lot of fun being in the software industry because you can take it so many different directions and there's so many different ways to do the same task.
Right. Well, today as we focus on fax, it actually has quite an interesting history. I've learned there's a technology historian out of Texas A&M. He's written a book called Faxed, The Rise and Fall of the Fax Machine. The facsimile machine, as it was originally known, he says, has roots back to the 1840s. So he claims that fax dates back even before those words, "Mr. Watson, come here, I want to see you," were famously spoken by Alexander Graham Bell on the first phone call to Thomas Watson on March the 10th, 1876.
That is correct. The whole market as an industry is really been interesting because it's been a long time since data needs to get from point A to point B and the ways to deliver it. Fax has been the most reliable way of doing that for many years.
So it was over a century before fax really came into prominence during the 80s. You know, the movie Back to the Future 2 kind of laid out a vision in 1989 that everybody would have a fax machine in their house. And when I started working for AT&T in 1995, they sold fax machines, and I would support those. And I even carried in my work van rolls of that thermal fax paper.
Mm-hmm.
What I read was at its peak in 1997, 3.6 million fax machines were sold in the U.S. It's interesting. I made note, you're talking about 3 billion faxes that you guys are delivering, last year?
Yep. It's staggering, the numbers. And what's interesting is, you know, when I started in the industry in 94, they said, you know, with the invention of email and everything else, that fax isn't going to be around for more than about 10 or 15 years. And I was like, okay, well, you know, it's my industry. I'm going to do the best I can with it anyway. And as a, you know, one of our global fax service market sources that we use, Ariston, they put out a study and it said that in 2018, there was a growth of about 5% of faxes. So the fax industry, while, you know, it hasn't gone down at all, it is still growing. The growth rate has been slowing a little bit, but they're predicting by the year 2022 that they're still going to have over a 2% growth rate in fax traffic. So it's not going anywhere.
That is really interesting. You talk about fax, and a lot of people think it's a dead technology, but yet it's really not. It's growing. That is quite interesting.
Yeah, and what you were saying with the fax machines in everybody's home, when people think about fax being dead, it's probably that image of the fax machine in everybody's house. Because
right.
Honestly, they don't sell that many of those fax machines anymore. Yeah, there's the multifunction device that can handle fax on occasion. But most of the faxing we've come across in our business is corporate faxing. When you're talking about companies that need to send faxes to other companies, insurance agents that have to get their forms filled out, doctors that have to get their prescriptions done, all of these documents that are being transferred from point A to point B, it's a lot of corporate fax, and that's what's growing in the marketplace today. You're right, the individual fax machines, they definitely peaked back in 97.
So what keeps faxing around?
So faxing is kept around mostly, I'd have to say, it's more with the regulations that are in the marketplace. When you talk about things like SOX compliancy and HIPAA compliancy, where organizations have to be able to produce the transaction of the data. I love to talk about being from Baltimore area. I'm a Ravens fan, and I like to tell the story that the Ravens won a Super Bowl because of the fax machine. You know, when free agency's around, you have to fax a contract in, and if it's not in by midnight, the player on the other side of midnight becomes a free agent. And Elvis Dumerville with the Denver Broncos had come to agreements with a contract and went to fax it to the team, and it didn't get there by midnight.
Oh.
So he became a free agent, and he tested the waters and came to Baltimore and won a Super Bowl for us.
How about that now?
So it really plays a lot more than what people think it does.
What are some of the challenges that customers are facing with faxing today?
I look at the challenges. There's probably four areas that we see the most of. Number one, we already kind of talked about it, is to get rid of that old fax machine. We don't really want to have the individual fax machines that you have to have, like you said, the thermal paper or anything. Most of them are now plain paper, mm-hmm. but they're still separate devices on the network that have to be maintained. And a lot of people want to get rid of those. By doing that, though, it comes into the second challenge, which is costs. You know, the cost of faxing is pretty high when you look at the transaction of documents, and they want to lower it as much as possible to keep their bottom line. So by us allowing them to get rid of like extra phone lines when you have to run analog phone lines to the fax machines and things, you can really kind of cut into those costs and bring that down. And then, as I mentioned, the compliance is one of those big drivers, making sure that you are in compliant It's interesting because GDPR, we heard a lot about this a few months ago or about a year ago. Europe adopted GDPR, which is just a way of compliance with data that's within your organization and how you're supposed to handle it. And what a lot of U.S. companies are finding out is because the European Union adopted GDPR, if they do business and transact business in the European Union, they then have to be GDPR compliant. So even though it's not a U.S. regulation, most of our companies in the U.S. have to comply by this regulation. And so we help them get there with all of the different types of compliance structures that are out there. And then the last one, you know, with the earthquake that just recently happened in California, you can understand that high availability and disaster recovery is important parts of any infrastructure with a business. And for those insurance companies to be able to take those claims and move that information around quickly so that they can pay out and let people rebuild their lives, disaster recovery is important for those faxes so that that information can get across and we can see that information travel. So making sure that they're up, always online, and if something should happen where it goes down, that they're back and up and running as quickly as possible. That's another one of those challenges that we find our customers coming to us to discuss.
Okay. Can you talk a little bit about your solution? You talk about getting rid of the fax machine. You're still talking about faxing, though. Can you talk a little bit about your solution and how you go about sending and receiving faxes?
Yeah, that's one of the best parts of going to a centralized fax server environment. You can still use some of the devices. When we look at fax machines, most of those were put in the marketplace because of ease of use. You didn't want your employees to have to get up and walk across the building or the campus in order to send a fax. So they would run phone lines and put all of these machines in place so that you could get up from your desk, walk over a couple of feet, and then scan it into your fax machine. What we've done is we kind of replaced that fax machine with a multifunction printer. So now you can walk up to the device and scan your document right there and send that through. However, we've also learned that most people don't even have hard copies of the things that they're sending. So they want to be able to send a digital document, and instead of printing it out, walking it to the fax machine, scanning it in, we just have a print driver that automatically captures the data and allows you to type the phone number in and send right from your desktop. You can do that through the print driver, and that gives us the ability to integrate with so many different applications on the market, because if you can print from Windows, you can fax it. We also integrate with email systems, so that all you have to do is type out a fax number at a faxdomain.com type of thing and hit send after you attach the documents you want faxed. And then we'll take that from the email environment and automatically fax it for you. And all of those things, we still want to get that regulation or that audit trail. We know what the user is and we can send notifications back right to the desktop. So that old person that got up and walked to the fax machine and waited there until that fax went and got the confirmation page printout, they can now hit print, send it off, and then just wait for the email to come back that says it went successfully at this date and time. So the whole trail is still there. We cover it from end to end, and they have an easy way of handling the delivery. And then, of course, there's always the mobile market. You know, the mobile market is there. There's iPads, there's iPhones, there's Androids. Pretty much any device nowadays, people are keeping connected to their network and their email environments. And so we have applications that can run on those devices and give you access to your faxes as well. So a new fax comes in and I'm at the airport, I can just open up my XMedius fax client and look at the new fax that came in and see the information right in front of me. And then if I need to, I can forward that and send it on to somebody else either via email, or I can fax it right from that device as well.
Sounds like it's pretty easy to use.
It's very easy to use. In fact, we've gone through and tried to make our multifunction device connectors. So we have all those connectors for your Xerox, your HP, Canon, Toshiba, pretty much any device that you have out there. We've tried to keep those connectors so that you get the same experience as sending a fax. So even though you walk up to the device and scan it, you can send it. The multifunction interface works the same way. We try to give you the ability to just walk up, scan it, type in the fax number, and hit send. And then the email, everybody's already used to send an email, so that's really simple as well.
Mm-hmm. What are some of the market drivers for customers to use your solution?
So the market drivers, again, we get back to regulation. That's one of the biggest ones that people come to us about. But Another large one is the whole migration to the voice over IP environment. You know, a lot of people are changing out their phone systems, their old PBXs and things. They're not doing it. As Tom probably mentioned, it's one of the reasons we get a lot of interest in our XM Connect product. Mm-hmm. The XM Fax product is a part of that system. You know, when you replace a voice system, a lot of times people aren't thinking about the fax traffic part of it. They put in the whole new voice system and then their fax machine stopped working because now they're trying to force those old traditional voice lines over a voice over IP network without taking into consideration that you can do it better. That whole T38 fax over IP market, G711, we can handle all of those capabilities on the back end right from your gateways and bring that in and make sure that the fax traffic can be dealt with reliably in those kind of environments. And then, of course, there's the ROI. You know, people are looking at those fax machines and trying to get return on investment for upgrading those machines, and there is none when you talk about upgrading the machines. So by going to the fax server, we can give them savings that they can use towards other parts of the business. So whether it's cutting down on the hardware, cutting down on the phone line charges, or cutting down on the time and management of the faxes, automatically integrating into some of your applications. Automation's a big point as well. We have connectors in our system that allow us to seamlessly connect with a number of different CRM or ERP applications so that when faxes come in, you can drop them right off into a workflow and have those as a part of a doc management system. We can archive them immediately, and you can do different things with those faxes. So that automation point really does help out on the market as well. And it's another driver that people come to us saying, hey, we need to be able to fax out of this ERP or this CRM or this healthcare application. And we have connectors for those.
Okay. Do you find some verticals you do more faxing than others?
So yes, probably the biggest vertical in the market that does faxing is healthcare. Probably 30% of the business is done in healthcare market. And that's because of patient records, HIPAA regulations, prescriptions, lab results, insurance forms, everything along that line. Healthcare is a big part. But government is also big. You know, you're probably maybe 10% less. You're probably the 20% market there, where they do letters, petitions, requests, legislation. You know, one of the things that we work with is the U.S. government so that, you know, a House of Representatives can go and fax information back to the local offices and they have copies of the documents that were just passed within the laws in Congress. So education is also pretty high because when you think about education, it kind of covers some of the other areas. For example, the financial aid forms, student loans, that's there from the financial industry. But then they also do healthcare because every student coming in has to have their health forms and those kind of pieces of information back to the university so that they can know that they're healthy and ready to go. And if there are any problems, they can cover the insurance claims and those types of things. And we also see some manufacturing as well as the finance. So both of those around that probably that 10% market where mortgage loan applications, those type of things, you know, forms, product plans, recipes for products, those kind of things get faxed across.
Well, tell us, why is XM Fax the best solution for those markets?
Our competitive advantages, they really come into place when we're talking about things like scalability. Our product can handle over 300 fax calls simultaneously on a single machine. We do scale extremely well. When you're talking about a small company having the same kind of piece of software, that's where we get into some of the benefits because most of the cost around the solution is about how many channels you need. So that four-channel person can handle it, but let's say that four-channel customer got bought by a larger company, we can scale up using the same exact software all the way to 300 channels. We can go way over 300 channels by just putting in additional call servers. So it's just something else that needs to process. But a single box can handle 300 channels. And honestly, we don't have a ton of customers that need more than 300 channels of fax, but we do have a few of them that are out there using it. The reliability of the products, with our high available solution that we offer, we have automatic failover between two systems. And everything that's done on system A is done on system B, and there's no loss of time that's in the marketplace. So we are extremely reliable from that aspect, and we can help give you that 99.9% uptime that you require in a fax world. And when you think about trades being done from a financial institution, a single trade can be worth millions of dollars, and it has to go through, or the business doesn't get transacted. So you want to make sure that your system is up 24/7, and we can give you that capability. And one of the other benefits we offer is something we call floating channels. If you have a system that has, you know, 100 channels worth of fax, and you have two servers running in high availability, you're probably running 50 and 50. But if one of those goes down, we can transfer those 50 licenses to the other one and run it 100 licenses so that you never miss any calls during your downtime from that other server. The main system continues to run and operate. You bring that second server back online, and it splits the traffic back between the two. So you get a load balancing while they're both active, but you have full capacity if one goes down while you're rebuilding it or upgrading it, virus checking, that kind of stuff. Other advantages are, you know, simplicity. The fact that, you know, like we talked about, the client access is very easy for the users. Security is also a very big player. People want to make sure that they're locking down. You know, I walked into my own doctor's office recently, and the fax machine is sitting up on the counter. A fax comes in, and I just leaned over to the doctor and told him that if you didn't realize that you're in HIPAA violation right now, and they asked why, and I said, because your fax is sitting on the fax machine, and I can read it. And that may be pertaining to another patient. Well, in our environment, you can securely deliver that fax right into their email or into an application so that they have to log in to be able to see it, and therefore restrict that access to your everyday user to the personal information that's out there.
I chuckled then. My background has been through the PBX side of this world that we work in, and I go in places and I always notice the phones on the desk. I'm hearing you go into places and you notice the fax machines and stuff that are around. You talk about reliability, high availability, the failover. It made me think about the deployment options. What are the deployment options for XM Fax? Is it premise-based, cloud-based?
Well, the answer to that question is yes. Mm-hmm. The XMedius Fax product, XM Fax, we've really designed it with a bunch of features. And so we offer the premise-based software so that you can install it on your own network. Some of our customers require this because they want to have full control over the environment, so we allow that. We also have cloud offerings, which means that you don't even have to install any software in your location unless you want the print driver. You might put that on a couple desktops. And you can communicate to the fax traffic in a completely secure connection out to the cloud and let the cloud do all the telephony work for you. Or you can use a hybrid method. XM Fax has a hybrid mode, which allows you to have a server located on your network that handles all of the interactions with your clients, but the telephony part is pushed out to the cloud. So the phone call itself is made from a cloud solution, and you never have to worry, is my network capable of doing fax over IP or T38? Because all the telephony is done in the cloud. So you make a secure connection from the fax server that's on your location to the cloud for the telephony part, and out it goes. And we can receive the same way and return that right back into the fax server. So you get notifications right to your desktop that a new fax came in, even though it's a cloud offering. We handle all three environments completely well. All the features that you get on the premise are available in the cloud. So, you know, print to fax, connectors, a few things may need to change a little bit on how it connects. But from the standpoint of feature-rich capabilities, they're all there.
So when you're looking at a fax solution, you want something that's fast and reliable, that works over internet technology. XM Fax is reliable, secure, and it's easy to use. XMedius is a company that has been in business over 20 years with experience and thousands of satisfied customers that trust your expertise. Rich, thank you for sharing your knowledge of XMedius Fax Solutions today.
Oh, it was my pleasure. Anytime.
If you missed the previous podcast with XMedius, check out the episode XM Connect Enterprise Class Unified Communications, released June 30th of this year. XMedius will also be at the Hiscall Technology Showcase, along with many other of our vendor partners, on August the 15th. Listen to the podcast and come by the HTS to get your questions answered. Lastly, we greatly appreciate you listening to the Hiscall Technology Podcast. As you continue to listen and enjoy the episodes, leave an encouraging review or give us a 5-star rating to help podcast promotion and other people find the podcast. Until our next episode, don't be afraid, just believe.
Thanks for taking the time to listen to the His Call Technology Podcast. Subscribe to this podcast so you can stay up to date with today's business communication trends. To learn more about His Call solutions for your business needs or to listen to previous podcasts, visit us at our website, hiscall.com.